Well, I was born and reared on a farm.
I grew up on a farm in Nebraska.
We grew up on a small farm. We didn't have anything.
I suppose they'd like to say you could take the boy away from the farm, you never take the farm out of the boy. And so agriculture is something I've always been interested in, and as a result, I wanted to continue in that area.
Decided, my dad said he could either give me some land or help me go to college. Which one would you like? And I said, well, I would like to go to college, and so.
Actually, not that I'm bragging, but school was fairly easy for me, and I think they recognized the fact that I probably should go on. In fact, I skipped the second grade.
Particularly, we were the first in our families to go on to college.
Well, I was a chemistry major at Brigham Young University, and a man by the name of Thomas L. Martin, soil microbiologist, who was a good teacher, was one who interested me in the subject of agronomy.
Finally, a PhD from the University of Nebraska.
Mm-hmm. My first year at Wells, I was an English major, but my English professor there was not very encouraging. And so when I took my sophomore course in ecology, I just fell in love with it. My ecology professor. He had us out looking at salamanders at night.
Tremendous experience. In fact, I went to the University of Tennessee in Martin. And I think I told you I was the first woman to go through the general ag program and get a degree in agriculture.
Well, when I got there and they saw how much chemistry I had, they said, well, you could either get a master's degree or you can just go from a bachelor's degree to a PhD.
Exactly. I was using one of Odom's first textbooks, and he certainly was one of the key people in the area, and so ecology was brand new.
Yeah, I got a bachelor's at Illinois and a master's at Illinois,
so
then I did a bunch of things. I went to Michigan State, and then the Army decided I ought to go with the Army.
I went right on, straight through, got my PhD at North Carolina State. I was the second person in the agronomy department to get a PhD from the University of North Carolina, the overall University of North Carolina.
I'm Martin Massengale at the University of Nebraska at the present time. I first joined the American Society of Agronomy in 1954.
And I was remembering when I attended my first agronomy meeting.
What year was that? I'm
trying to fish for the date. It might have been 1953 or something like that. I wasn't a member at the time. I was a graduate student. But I was in a session where Norman Borlaug made the major presentation. And that so inspired me. I couldn't ever forget that. I can still see him standing behind that podium making a presentation.
Another thing these meetings were good about.
Yes, yeah.
I used to spend when I was working, I would spend most of my time at meetings in the halls outside of the sessions.
Talking to people.
You can always read the abstract, but you can't talk to the warm body that you get a chance to talk to at the meetings. And learned a great deal in the halls. of the meetings. The annual meetings, to me, are a really important part of the society.
But anyway, we came up with the solution, the tri-society solution, that allowed each one of them to have presidents and executive committees, and yet to form a mechanism so that they could have an overall, what was called the Agronomy Society.
And that had been the friend of Norman Borlaug's ever since, I guess, or maybe there were some times in there. He didn't know who I was, but I knew who he was, and in recent years we've had a lot of associations together.
And I thought it was a good book.
Yeah?
I never dreamed that I'd ever have anything to do with it afterwards, but I kept my copy.
At the University of Wisconsin, I worked mainly in the soil science department. I was there 5 years, and the last 3 years I worked mainly in the soil science department, and I was the only female. And I felt no discrimination at all. Those were just glorious years where it was so stimulating, and I was in an ivory tower there, working with leaders in soil physics, Wilfred Gardner, Champ Tanner, Peter Rotz, Miller over in the physics department, you name it. I was working with the top people in soil physics.
When you ask about my first trip out with scientists,
that's what you think of?
When I go back to my college days, it's really great what you have. Except I guess I could go one step further back and say every trip out to the field I made with my father was going out with a scientist too.
Mm-hmm.
And he is very much part of the beginning of my interest in agriculture.
And at the end of the time, I suddenly realized that those tillers were coming out in the pattern with the leaves like a scroll. And if you were pulling the scroll out, when it came time on the leaf number, when the tiller ought to show up, it was showing up regardless of these light levels and rates at which things were happening. And so I made him a jelly donut bet that they would be able to, on Monday, we would be able to lay out a scroll of paper and chart these things out parallel to one another. So that was the jelly donut bit was one of my big memories.
Well, working with Buckman, and they wanted me to be sure that I gained everything from him because he was an excellent teacher. And then I started teaching in class. He asked me if I would like to join him in the revision. Four editions had already gone by, and he wanted me to work with him in the fifth. And I was quite eager to do so. Unfortunately, I discovered, and he discovered, soon after we made that decision, that he had Parkinson's. And so it was not possible for him to do much. Mm-hmm. And so even though it was my first time with him, even the fifth edition was basically one that I had responsibility for because he was ill.